Hello everyone, my name is Asish and welcome to the course of data structure. So guys, in the previous lecture we have discussed about a difference between a singly linked list, a doubly linked list and a circular linked list. So guys, in this series of a data structure I have covered the topic like stack, queue and linked list. And guys, if you want to learn about a stack, queue and linked list, then you can go and visit my previous lectures. Okay. So guys, in this lecture we will discuss a tree data structure and its type. So let's start the lecture of tree data structure. So guys, what is a tree data structure? A tree is a recursive data structure containing the set of one or more data nodes, where one node is designated as the root of the tree while the remaining nodes are called as the children of the root. So guys, the tree data structure is the collection of the nodes where the one node is defined as a root node and all the other nodes are taken as a children of that root node. Okay, so let's go and see how to represent a tree node. Okay, so guys, let's say that that we have a node A, okay, and this is the root node. Okay, and guys, the root node A has the three child nodes. So let's say that the B is the child node of A and C is the child node of A and D is the child node of A, and the B has the two more child nodes as E and F. Okay, and D has the two more child nodes as H and G. So guys, A is a root node, okay, and the node A has the two child node as B and C, and the B has a child node as E and F, and D has a child node as H and G. And guys, E and F are the child nodes of B. So guys, the B is the parent of E and F. Okay, so guys, the nodes other than the root node are partitioned in the non-empty set where the each node, where the each one of them are called as a subtree. So guys, here this A, B, E, F are called as one subtree, okay, and A to C is a one subtree, and A, D, H, G is a one subtree. So guys, total we have the three subtrees in this tree structure. Okay, so T1 is like A, B, E and F, and A and C is the second subtree, and A, D, H, G is a third subtree. Okay, so guys, the nodes of a tree either maintain a parent child relationship between them or they are the sister nodes. So guys, here the A and B is as a parent child relationship and B, C as a sister node or a sibling nodes, and C and D is a sister nodes. Okay, so guys, in general tree, a node can have any number of children nodes, but it can have only one single parent node. So guys, as we can see that the B has the two childrens, okay, E and F, but E and F has only one parent node. So B is the parent node of E and F. So guys, in general tree, a node can have any number of children, as we can see that E and F are the two childrens, but it can have only one single parent, as B is a one single parent, and T1, T2 and T3 are the subtrees. Like this is the subtree, okay, so this is the subtree and this is the subtree and this is the subtree. Okay guys, so guys, this is the structure of a tree. So guys, there are some terms which are used in a tree, like a root node. Okay, so guys, the root node is the topmost node in a tree hierarchy. Like here, A node is a topmost node. So this is the root node of a of this tree structure. And guys, the root node is one of which does not have any parent. So guys, we can see that A does not have any parent. So root is the topmost node and it does not have any parent. So this type of nodes are called as the root node. And the subtree, so guys, there is a term you use in a tree as a subtree. So guys, if the root node is not null, the tree T1, T2, T3, okay, T1, T2, T3 is called as a subtree of the root node. Okay, so this T1 has A, B, E, F, and A and C is like the another subtree, and A, D, G, H is another subtree. So this is the subtree. Okay, so guys, the next term is used in a tree as a leaf node. So guys, the node of a tree which does not have any child node. So guys, it is a node of a tree which does not have any child node present is called as a leaf node. So guys, here we can see that E and F and G and H does not have any child nodes. Okay, so these are the leaf of a this tree structure. Okay, so guys, there can be any number of leaf nodes present in a general tree. A leaf node can also called as external nodes. So guys, E and F are the leaf node and these are also called as external nodes. Okay, and there can be any number of leaf nodes. Okay guys, so these are the leaf nodes. The next term used in a tree is like a path. So guys, what is a path? So guys, the sequence of a consecutive edges is called as path in a tree. Okay, so guys, in this tree we can see that A, B and E has one path. Okay, and A, B, F has one path, and A and C has one path, and A, D, H has one path. So these are the path. Okay guys, the sequence of the consecutive edges is called as a path. So guys, here A, B, E has one path. Okay, so guys, this is a path in a tree. So guys, the one word is used as a degree. So what is a degree in a tree? So guys, a degree term is used for a node. So guys, degree of a node is equal to the number of children's a node have. So guys, as a B node has the two children's like E and F, so guys, we can say that the B has two degree. And guys, in the same way, D have the two children's like F and G, so we can see that say that D has a two degree, correct? And the degree of a leaf node is always zero, while in a complete leaf tree, degree of each node is equal to two. So guys, here we can say that E and F has a zero degree because leaf or the external nodes does not have any degree or a child node. Correct, guys? So that's why E and F has a zero node, degree, and B node has a two degree. And C does not have any degree, it is of a zero degree, and F and G has a zero degree, but D node has a two degree. Okay, so guys, a degree is a term is used in a tree and it represent a node having the number of children's. Clear guys? The next term is used as a label number. So guys, what is a label number in a tree? Each node of a tree is assigned a label number in such a way that each node is present at one label higher than its parent node. Okay, so guys, here we can say that node A has one label. So let's say the root has the always label 0. Okay guys, label 0, and this B, C, D has one label as label 1, and E, F, G, H, these are the leaves, and it has one label like label 2. So guys, here the one important thing is that the root node always have a label 0, and after that guys, the nodes like B, C or D are of label 1. Okay, and A has a label 0, and E, F, G, H has a label 2. So this is the term label is used. Okay, so guys, the each node of a tree is assigned a label number in such a way that each node is present at one label higher than its parent. Okay guys, and the root node of the tree is always present at a label 0. So guys, the another term is used in a tree as the ancestors. Okay, So guys, the ancestor of a node is in any preceded node of a path from the root of that node. The root node does not have any ancestors. Okay guys, so guys, we can say that A, B, F are the ancestors. Okay guys, and here A, B, E has a ancestor, correct? So guys, here we can say that F have the two ancestors like B and A, and E has a two ancestors like B and A, and H has a two ancestors like D and A. So guys, the ancestor is the term used in a tree. Okay guys, so these are the some terms which you should know about a tree, and we are going to use these terms in our further lecture. Okay guys, so these are the terms like, so guys, the terms like we have the terms like the root node. So guys, the root node, guys, the root and node A is a root node and it is the topmost node. Okay, so guys, the next term we have seen, the subtrees, the subtrees like A, B, E, F is a subtree. Okay guys, T1, T2, T3. So guys, these are the three subtrees we have used in this tree structure. The next term we have learned is like a leaf node. So guys, the leaf node are also called as external nodes. E, F, H, G are the leaf nodes, and this node does not have any child node. Okay, so guys, the next we have seen is a path. So guys, we can see that A, B, E has one path, okay, and A, B, H has one path, and A and C has one path. So guys, the sequence of a consecutive edges is called as path. So guys, the next term we have used as the degree. So guys, the degree is the a node containing a child node is called as a degree. So guys, here the B has a two child, that's why B has a degree of 2, and the C does not have any child, so C has a degree of 0. And guys, the leaf nodes always have a degree 0, because as we know that the leaf does not contain any child node. So guys, the next term we have learned is like a label number. So guys, the label number like A has a always label 0, as it is a root node, and the B and C, D has a label 1, and E and F, G, H has a label 2. So these are the terms we are going to use in our tree session. So these are the terms which you should know. Okay, so guys, the next guys, where are the trees are used in a real world example or in a like a real world example? So guys, in a real world applications like in a Google Map, the tree data structure work on the various applications like a Google Map works on a tree to find the shortest path from one place to another place. So guys, the application like the Google Map uses a tree structure to find the shortest path between a one place to a another place. So guys, the tree has a real life applications is like a Google Map. Okay, so guys, the next we are going to see what are the types of the tree. Okay, so guys, the types of the tree can be like a general tree or forest tree or a binary tree or a binary search tree, expression tree or a tournament tree. Okay, so guys, these are the six different types of trees. So guys, the first is a general tree, second is the forest tree, third is the binary tree, fourth is the binary search tree, and fifth is the expression tree, and sixth is the tournament tree. So guys, we are going to see one by one all the types of a tree. So first let's see about a general tree. So let's go to here and let's create a graphical representation of a general tree. So guys, what is a general tree? So guys, the general tree is the one of the type of a tree. In general tree, so guys, the general tree stores the element in a hierarchy order in which the top level element is always present as at a level 0 as a root element. So let's guys, first I will draw a simple general tree structure. Okay, so guys, let's say that this is a node A and this is the root node. Okay, and the node A has the child as B and C and one more child as D. So guys, the B, C, D are the child nodes of node A, and the node B has the child as E and F. Okay, and guys, F has two more child, So guys, the f has two more child as I and j, and guys the c, so guys the d has the two more child as g and h. So guys, in this structure we can say that a is the root node and the b and c are b, c and d are the child nodes. Okay, so b, c and d are the child node, and e and f is the child node of a, and I and j are the child node of f, and f is the parent of I and j, and I, j are the leaf nodes. Okay, and e is also a leaf node because e does not have any child node and I and j does not have any child node. Correct. So this is a general tree structure, guys. So guys, in general tree stores the element in a hierarchy order. Okay, it is storing in a hierarchy order in which the top level element is always at a label 0. So guys, as we have discussed that the root node has a always label 0. So this has a label 0. All the node except the root node are present at a number of labels. So guys, here we can say that B, C, D has one label, like let's see, it has a label 1, and E, F, G, H has one label, like label 2, and guys here I and J has one label, let's say as a label 3. So guys, each nodes contain in a have some label. So guys, the node which are present on the same label are called as a siblings, while the node which are present on a different labels exhibit the parent child relationship. So guys, B and C and D are on a same label, that's why we can say that B and C are the siblings or a sister nodes. Okay, in the same way guys, E, F, G, H are the siblings or a sister nodes, as these nodes are present in a label 2. And I and J are the sister nodes or the sibling nodes because these nodes are present in a same label. And guys, the nodes which are present at a different label, like A and B are present in a different label, like A is present in label 0 and B is present in label 1. So that's why this form a parent-child relationship. So guys, A is a parent of B and B is a child of A. So that's why A and B having a parent-child relationship. In the same way guys, B is on label 1 and E and F are on label 2. So that's why guys, E and B have a parent-child relationship and B and F have a parent-child relationship. In the same way, D and G have a parent-child relationship. Okay. So these, so guys, the nodes which are present on different labels form a parent-child relationship. A node may contain any number of sub trees. So guys, the node A has the three sub trees as T1, T2 and T3. Okay guys, so this is the sub tree, correct, as we have seen in the earlier structure also. So this is a sub tree. So guys, this is example of a general tree. Okay, and the tree in which each node contains the three sub tree is called a ternary tree. So guys, we can see that this is a ternary tree in which it has a three sub trees. Okay, so this is example of a general tree, and these are the terms we have seen, that label 1, label 2, label 1, label 2, level 3. Okay, and the siblings and the sisters node and the leaf node as I and J. Okay guys, so guys, the next the type we are going to discuss as a forest tree. So guys, we have seen about a general tree, and now we will see what is a forest tree. So guys, the forest tree can be defined as a set of disjoint trees which can be obtained by deleting a root node and the edge which connecting the root node of the first label node. So guys, what if I delete a root node A and this path? So guys, if I delete this A and this node, then guys only we are left with this part. Okay, so this part is called as a forest tree. Okay guys, so forest trees can be defined as a set of disjoint trees which can be obtained by deleting the root node and the edge which connects the root node to the first label node. Okay, so guys, B, E, F, I, J has one forest node. So let's say this has one forest one. Okay, and guys, A and C is a one forest node. C has one forest node, because guys, we are removing the root node and its path. So this can now, so guys, the C is left. So C is called one forest node. And guys, after removing the node, the root node A and its path, then only we are left with D, G, H. So this is called as forest path. So this is F2 and this is F3. Okay guys, so this is the forest 3, this is the forest 2 and this is the forest 1. So this is the forest tree. Okay guys, after removing the node tree, the remaining nodes are called as a forest. Correct guys? So guys, we have seen the general tree and a forest tree, right? So next we have the type as, so guys, next we have a type as a binary tree. So guys, what is a binary tree? So let me erase this. Okay, so now we will see, so guys, what is a binary tree? A binary tree is a data structure in which each node can have at most two children. So guys, a node can have at most two children present, are called as a binary tree. Okay, so let's say that A has a root node, and guys, the A can have only two children, like B and C. Okay, and the guys, C can have only two children at most, like D and E, and C can have the two children like F and G. Okay, so guys, here in binary tree, so guys, the binary tree is a data structure in which each node can have at most two children. The node present at the topmost level is called as a root tree. So guys, A is a root tree, and the node with the zero children is called as a leaf node. So guys, here, so guys, let's consider that E has also node like I and J. Okay, so guys, here I and J are the leaf node because this node does not contain any children, and F and G and D are the leaf nodes because it is not contain any child node. So guys, the binary trees are used in the applications like expression evolution and the many more. So guys, this is a binary tree. So guys, the main point is like a general tree and a binary tree, the difference is like in binary tree, a node can have at most two child nodes. Okay, so guys, this is a binary tree. So guys, we will discuss the more about binary tree in our coming lectures. Okay, so guys, I hope you understand what is a binary tree. A binary tree is a tree of a data structure in which each node can have at most two children. Okay, so like guys, A has a root node which contains two children B and C, and B has the two children like E and D and E, and C has the two children like F and G. So this is the example of a binary tree. Okay, so next we are going to discuss about the binary search tree. Okay, so binary search tree is also the one of the type of a tree data structure. Okay guys, so binary search tree is an older binary tree. So guys, the difference between a binary tree and a binary search tree is that a binary search tree is an ordered binary tree. All the element in the left subtrees are lesser than the root. So guys, the difference is that in binary search tree, the value of all the nodes in the left child will be less than the root, while the element present in the right subtree are greater than or equal to the root node element. So guys, let's create a graphical representation of a binary search tree, and guys, we will see the difference between a binary tree and a binary search tree. So let's create A has a node as a root node, and guys, as we know that the binary tree has a two children. Okay, so let's say that this has a and this has a B node and this has a C children. And guys, the B has also a two children like C and D. Okay, and guys, C has no children. Okay, so guys, in binary subtree, In binary search, consider that guys the one parent node with a value 30. So let's take this as a value 30. Okay, so guys A has a value of 30 and it has a left child node, which, so guys the A has a two nodes. The one has a child, the left child, and C is a right child and B is the left child, right? So guys the B has a two child, C and D. C will be the left child and D will be the right child, okay? So guys I will use the term like a left child and right child. The left child will represent the left child side, okay, and the right child will represent the right side of children node. So here the B will be the left side children and the C will be the right children, okay, of A. So guys let's say that A has a value 30 and it has a left child, that is B node, which value is will be less than 30. So let's say that B has a value 25, okay, and guys the right child of A will have a value equal to 30 or a greater than 30. So let's say that we take the value as 35. So guys the C has a value 35 and B has a value 25. So guys these are the rules for a binary search tree, okay guys. So rules can is like the each node have only a two child node, that is the left child and a right child. The left child value will be less than a root node always, okay guys. Always the left child value will be less than a root node value, and the right child value will be equal to the root node value or it will be a greater than a root node value. So guys here we are taking the root node value as 30, so the left children value is 25 and the right side value is 35, okay, it is greater than root 30 value, okay. So now guys here the B has the two children, C and D, as a C is the left and the D is the right. So guys the rule is like the left children will have the lesser value than a root value. So guys the C will be 20, let's say C has a 20 and the D is the right, right? So it will be greater than its root or equal to root. So let's keep as greater than 30 or 32, let's keep as 32, okay guys. So this is the rule for a binary search tree. And guys the another property of a binary search tree is that any parent node must have at least two children node. So guys these are the two rules we must follow if we want to implement a binary search tree implementation. So guys the first rule is that each node can have at most two children, as a left children and right children, right? And the left children value will always be lesser than its root value and the right children value will always have a value greater than or equals to its root value, okay guys. These are the some rules. Now guys consider the left node has the two nodes value, okay, as we have discussed, 20 and 32, right guys. So these are the rules for a binary search tree. So guys in the next lecture we will see how to implement and how to write our Java code or how to implement a method to insert an item in a binary search tree and how to delete a item from a binary search tree and also to print all the element present in a binary tree search tree, okay. So guys here we have discussed a binary subtree. I hope you understand about a binary search tree. In the next lecture we will see about the implementation. We will implement our Java custom class and a custom method to implement the some operations like to insert an element in the binary search tree and to delete an item from a binary search tree and also to print all the items in a binary search tree, okay. So guys the next type we will discuss now is like expression tree, okay. So guys let me first clear this. So guys what is expression tree? So guys expression tree are used to evaluate a simple arithmetic expressions, okay. The expressions tree is basically a binary tree where the internal nodes are represented by operator while the leaf node are represented by operands. So let me first draw, guys. So guys, let's consider that we have one equation like A plus B. Okay guys, A plus B divided by, in a bracket, let's say A multiply or into B minus C. Okay guys, and plus D. So guys, this is the expression we have to resolve in a form of a tree, and in a, by the use of expression tree. So guys, we have expression like A plus B inside a bracket, A plus B divided by A into B minus C, okay, inside a bracket, and plus D. So guys, this is expression we have to resolve by using expression tree. So guys, let's start this expression. So guys, as we know that expression tree are used to evaluate a simple arithmetic expression. So guys, this is arithmetic expression. So we have to use to evaluate a simple arithmetic expression by using a expression tree. So guys, expression tree is basically a binary tree. This is also a binary tree. Okay, remember, this is a binary tree. It means that it can have only a two children nodes at most. Clear? So guys, a binary tree will internally nodes are present, are represented by a operator. So guys, the internal nodes will be represented by a operator, and the external, that is the leaf nodes, will be represented by a operand. So guys, for this we can, so guys, we can draw like this. Let's keep this as a plus. So let us start from here, guys. So this is our root node as a plus, and so guys, this has one child node as D. Okay, and now guys, it has one more like divide. Okay, so I am using here the divide. So guys, this is the internal node, okay, and D is the external node. So guys, the, as we know that the external node will always have a operand, and the operator will be always present in the internal node. So this is the internal node, and here this is minus, and let's do this is plus. Okay, so guys, this is one of the internal node plus, and it has two child as A and B. So guys, this is A and this is B. So A plus B, so we have resolved this A plus B, and guys, we have to do, so guys, this is the division. Okay, so guys, this is the division, this is the division. Okay, so guys, here we will do the internal node will contain the operand, like we will say this is the minus part, and we will do the minus with C. So let's write here the leaf node or the external node is operand C, and the operator we are going to use the internal operator as a operator like into. So guys, here we will write into, and we will do into as A and B. Okay, A into B. So let's do the external node is the operand. So this is an operand as A and B and into. Okay, and after that we have to do minus C. So A into B and minus C. So we have resolved this in the expression, and guys, after that we have to divide with, so division is done here, and A plus B. So the output of this is like A plus B is divided by this whole bracket. So this is in a whole bracket here. So this is the part of this, and this is a part of this, and D is as a operand, and it is in the external leaf. So guys, in expression, so guys, we have resolved this expression by the use of a expression tree. So guys, expression tree are used to evaluate a simple arithmetic expression. As we have discussed, expressions tree is basically a binary tree where the internal nodes are represented by operators. So guys, we can see that the internal nodes are represented by a operators, okay, and the external or the leaves node are represented by a operands. So guys, A and B are the operands, A and B, C and D are the operands, and these are the external leaves or the leaves node or external nodes. Okay, so guys, this is the full example of a expression tree, and we have seen that how we so guys, the what is the use of a expression tree. So guys, the next type we are going to discuss is the tournament tree. So guys, let's discuss the tournament tree. So guys, the tournament tree is one of the type of a the tree data structure type. Okay, so guys, the tournament tree are used to record the winner of a match in each round. So guys, the tournament is used the tournament tree is used to find out the winner and the loser of the tournament, okay, of any tournament. So guys, the tournament tree are used to record the winner of the match in each round being played between the two players. So guys, in this, a two player do a match, and the one is the winner and one is the loser. So guys, the tournament tree can also be called as a selection tree or a winner tree. So guys, the other name of a tournament tree as a winner tree or a selection tree. The external nodes represent the players among which a match is being played, while the internal nodes present the winner of the match played. So guys, the leaf node or the external node that are present at the last nodes, okay, will play a match, and the one will won the match, and that will be go to the internal node. So let's draw a structure to see how the tournament tree work. Okay guys, so firstly I will draw a small example for you. So guys, before that we will see what are the type of a tournament trees. So guys, the tournament tree is of two type, like a winner tree and a loser tree. Okay, so guys, the two type of tournament trees are there, the winner tree and a loser tree. So guys, the winner tree is used to represent the winner of the tournament, and the loser tree is used to represent the loser of a tournament. Okay, hold a second guys. Yeah, so guys, the tournament tree has of two type, the winner tree and a loser tree. Okay, so guys, the winner tree, the completely binary tree in which the each node represent the smaller or a greater of it two children is called as a winner tree. So guys, let's consider some keys values. So guys, I am taking some keys values like 3, 5, okay, 3, 5, 6, 7, 20, and 8, and 2, and 1 value 9. So guys, this is 8, this is 2, and this is 9. This is 2 and this is 9. Okay, so guys, we are going to discuss the winner tree first. Okay, so these are the key values, like, or the items in a tree, like 3, 5, 6, 7, 20, 8, 3, 2 and 9. So guys, in the winner tree, we can make the winner of the winner to the maximum number or to the smallest number. So guys, here I will show or make the winner to the smallest number. So guys, as the minimum number is 2 here, so I'm going to make the winner to a 2. So let's draw the structure of this. So guys, as the winner is 2, so 2 will be always in a root. Okay, so let me guys first draw the diagram of this, and then I will explain you about the winner tree. So let's keep as 3, and this is 6, and 3 has the 2 children as 3 and 5, and 5 will play with 6, and 6 and 7 are the child nodes, and the 2 has this, and 2 has the 2 child nodes as 8 and 2. Okay, and 8 has the 2 child node as 20 and 8. Okay guys, I hope you can understand the structure guys, 2 and 9. So guys, this is the representation of a the winner tree in which I am going to make a winner to a the minimum number. So guys, the minimum number is 2. Okay, so minimum number is 2. So guys, the root element, so guys, the root node always have the winner. So guys, here the 2 is the winner. So guys, So guys, the 3 and 5 will have a match, and guys, in this always the smaller number will win. So guys, in this, the 3 and 5 will have a match. So guys, the 3 will win because 3 is the smallest number between 3 and 5. Okay, so guys, now inside this, 6 and 7 will have a match, and the 6 will win because the 6 is smaller than 7. Okay, so guys, now this 2 node will have a match. So guys, the 3 and 6 will have a match, and the 3 will win because 3 is the smaller. And now guys, in this branch, 20 and 8 will have a match, and 8 will win because 8 is smaller than 20. Okay, and 2 and 9 have a match. So guys, 2 will win because 2 is the smaller. And guys, 2 and 8 will have a match, and 2 will win because 2 is the smaller number. And guys, 2 and 3 will have a match, and the 2 will win because 2 is the smaller than 3. So guys, always the root have the winner. So guys, here I have make the tree structure in which I have made the winner, the smallest number as a winner. So guys, here the winner is 2. Okay, so guys, here, so guys, in this, the leaf node always have a match, and the internal node contains the winner. So guys, these are the leaf or the external nodes will have a match, and the inner will contain the winner. So 3 and 5 will have a match, and 3 will win because 3 is the smaller than 5. So guys, this is a winner structure of these values 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 20, 8, 2 and 9. I hope you understand about the winner tree, guys. The complete binary, so guys, this is a binary structure. So guys, as we can see that it has only the 2 children. Okay, so guys, the smallest node in the tree is represented by a root of the tree. So guys, so guys this is the winner here. Okay, so guys, next we are going to see the next type of this, like the tournament tree. So guys, the next type is like the loser tree. So guys, we have discussed about the winner tree, and guys, now we are going to discuss a loser tree. So guys, to make a loser tree, so guys, there are the 2 steps. So guys, in the first step, we have to first draw the minimum, the winner tree of a given data, as we have discussed earlier now only. So guys, firstly we will draw the winner of the minimum number, and then we will replace the internal nodes with the losers. Okay, so guys, the second step is like, so guys, the first step is that we will draw the winner tree graph, and then we will replace the winner the winner nodes with the loser nodes. Okay, so let's see so guys, how we can do that. So guys, let's take the keys now as 10, 2, 7, 6, 5, 9, 12 and 1. So guys, these are the keys or the element in a tree. Guys, 10, 2, 7, 6, 5, 9, 12, 11, 1. So guys, now I will make the winner to do a smallest number. So guys, here the smallest number in this list as a 1. So guys, the 1 will be the winner. Okay, but guys, I will draw a loser tree map. Okay, so guys, to draw the loser tree map, firstly we have to draw the winner tree map, and then we have to replace the winner nodes with the loser nodes. So first let's draw. So these are the keys, so let's separate them. And guys, here I'm going to divide into 2 parts so that it will, so guys, you will understand it better. So firstly I will draw here. So guys, firstly I have to draw the winner as a 1. So let's keep the 1 as a root. So this is a value, 1 is a winner. So let's draw as 2 and 1. Okay, and here the 2 and 6, and the 2 has, and 2 will, so here the 10 is the 2, 10 and 2 is the 2 child node. Okay, and 6 has a 2 child node as 7 and 6. Okay, and 1 you have like 5, and here 1, and 5 has 2, like 5 and 9. So guys, I hope you understanding the structure, because I don't have much space to show you, so that's why I'm making the structure in a small place. So guys, it has a structure like 12 and 1. Okay, so this is 1, this is 1, this is 2, this is 2, this is 6. So guys, the 2 and 10 have a match, and guys, we are making the smaller number as a win. So guys, 2 is smaller than 10, so that's why 2 will win. So we are going to keep the 2 in the inside a, like the inner node. Okay, so guys, 2 will be placed here. Now guys, 7 and 6 will have a match. 6 is the smallest number, so 6 is smaller than 7, so 6 will be placed in the inner node, okay, internal node. And guys, now the 2 and 6 will have a match, so 2 is smaller than 6, so 2 will be placed here. So guys, the same way 5 and 9 will have a match, 5 will win, and the 1 and 2 have a match, 1 and 12 will have a match, and 1 will win, and 1 and 5 will have a match, so guys, 1 will win. In the same way, 1 and 2 will have a match, and 1 will win. And guys, in the root, guys, as we said, that the winner is the smallest number, so 1 will win. So guys, this is the first step. So we have to, so guys, for the loser tree, we have to make the winner tree first. So guys, this is the winner tree, okay? So this is the first step. So now guys, the second step is, now we will store the loser of the match in each internal nodes. So guys, these are the internal nodes, like 2, 6, 5, 1, here 2 is the internal nodes. So now guys, we are going to replace all the, so guys, and 2 and 6 are the winners, okay? So for so guys, for the winner tree, we have assigned the winners at the place of the internal nodes, okay? So now guys, we are going to replace these internal nodes with a loser nodes. So guys, here the new structure will be, so guys, the new structure will be like like guys, 1 is the winner, okay? So we have to make the loser structure. So here the 2 will be placed here, and guys, so guys, here let's keep as 10 and 2, okay? So 10 and 2 will have a match, and guys, as a 2 has 2 has won the match, but we have to replace the 2 with a 10, because 10 is the loser. So replace this place with a 10. So let's keep as 10 here, okay? And guys, here the 10 is there. And guys, after that, guys, 6 and 7 have a match, and 6 has won. So now we have to replace this place with a 7. So let's take that 7 and 6 have a match, and here we have to replace with a 7. Okay. And now guys, 2 and 6 have a match, and 2 has won. So now we have to replace this 2 with a loser. So 6 was the loser, so we will replace this with a 6. So here the 6 will come, okay? So guys, this is the loser graph for one side. And now guys, in the same way, we have to draw about the another side, like 5 and 9 have a match, and guys, the loser is 9, so we have to replace the winner with a loser. So 9 will be here, 5 and 9, correct? And guys, in the same way, 12 and 1 have a match, and the winner was 1, so now we have to write the loser. So 12 was the loser, so 12, okay? And guys, in the same way, 1 and 5 have a match, so 1 was the winner, so we have to write a loser. So here guys, this is the graph of a loser. So guys, here we can say that by seeing this graph, the 1 is the winner, because in the root always the winner comes, and 2 is the loser, okay guys? So guys, the loser of the tournaments are listed here, like 6 is the loser, 10 and 7 are the loser, and the 5, 12 and 9 are the loser, and 2 are the, okay guys? So this is the list of the loser of a tournament. So guys, this is the example of a loser tree. So guys, the tournament tree has two types. The first type is the winner tree. So this is the graph of the winner tree. And the second is the loser tree. So guys, This is the loser tree. So guys, to get a loser tree, firstly we have to draw the winner tree, and then we have to replace the every internal nodes with a loser nodes. Okay, so as we have replaced the every internal nodes with a loser nodes, then we got the loser tournament, the losers tournament tree. So this is the loser tree. Okay guys, the complete binary tree for n players. Guys, here we have used the n players, correct guys? I hope you understand the this the tournament tree. Okay guys, so guys, the application of the tournament tree can be used in like it can be used to find a smallest and a largest element in an array. So guys, we can use a tournament tree to find the smallest and the largest element in array, and it can be also used for the sorting purpose also. Okay, and tournament tree may also be used in M-way merges, like, okay. So these are the some applications of a tournament tree. So guys, in this lecture we have discussed about the some of the different categories of a types of a trees, guys, like the general tree, forest tree, binary search tree, expression tree, and the tournament tree. Okay, so this, so guys, in this tournament we have discussed the tree and the types of tree. So guys, in the next lecture we will see and we will implement a binary search tree with our custom Java class, in which I will create a Java class, okay, and I will create my own custom method in which I will implement a basic operations in a binary search tree, like to insert an element, okay, to delete an element, and also to print all the elements inside a binary search tree. So guys, thank you, and thank you for watching this lecture. So see you in the next lecture. Thank you guys.